the latest.
Right, Kelly, it is, of course, a very somber mood here at the police, state police barracks in Greensburg, and we can only imagine what it's like for the family of Trooper Michael Stewart today. Trooper Lamani here at State Police just wrapped up a press conference about 30 minutes ago, clarifying exactly what happened this morning. He says the impact and the matchup between that garbage truck and the police cruiser likely what caused the death of Trooper Stewart this morning. He says that they were out on an unrelated call. Trooper Stewart was driving that vehicle. There was another trooper inside that vehicle as well. Trooper November is what we're hearing is the name of that man. They were traveling southbound on State Route 711 when a garbage truck was making a left-hand turn out of a parking lot there. The truck was driven by John Hissom from McKinchock Sanitation. He was not injured in that crash, and we're hearing that they sort of T-boned there. But of course, the garbage truck sits up higher than the cruiser, and the trooper Michael Stewart took more of the impact on his side of the vehicle. The other trooper inside that vehicle was flown to the hospital. He had pain, we're hearing, in his hip, also maybe some pelvis injuries and a concussion. But of course, this is a big loss for state police today. They say Trooper Stewart was a hometown guy. He was from Latrobe. He was 26 years old. We hear his birthday. He was turning 27 just next week. He was with Troop A for about 2 years now, since August of 2015, and they say he will be incredibly missed.
He was a big man with an even bigger heart and a bigger personality that went with it. He was extremely fun to be around, very charismatic, and pretty much he touched everybody that got to enjoy his company.
Now, Lamani said that the last time they lost a trooper in Troop A was 1992, and in total, in Troop A, they have only lost 8 members of their troop. Right now, they have launched a full-blown investigation trying to figure out exactly what happened. They say it could take weeks, though, to find out if anyone was at fault or if any charges will be filed in this crash. For now, reporting live in Westmoreland County, Brittany Hoke, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.